Good evening, everyone. My name is Yash Baheti, and I'm from IIT Roorkee. I've been associated with Ask IITians for past 2 years as a maths expert. And today we are going to discuss a question on area under the curve. This question was asked in IIT JEE 1998 for 8 marks in subjective exam. So this is a subjective question. So because this question was for 8 marks, remember that this is a very important question. If you understand each and every concept that are applied in this question, then it's well and good, and you're good to go. So what we have here, we have three functions here. One is y equals to 2x, one is y equals to x square, and another is y equals to fx. So here this is the y equals to 2x, y equals to x square, and some arbitrary function y equals to fx. Now, what we have to find out, the question says that for any point on this curve, y equals to x square, for x less than 1, area between these two curves, say y equals to 2x, and area between this y equals to x square and y equals to ft is equal. So the question is saying that these two areas, let's say this area and this area, is equal. So what we have to do is, if these areas are equal, then we have to find that what is that third function y equals to fx. So we have to find out equation of this function. What is the equation of this function is? Okay, so let's say this point be any point, say P. Let's say this point be a Q and this point be R. So the question says that the area OQP equals to area ORP. This is what we have given, and we have to find out that y equals to fx. So let's try to find out what the equation of this function is. So first we'll try to find out the area of ORPO, that means this part. We are going to find out the area of this part. So we know that this function is y equals to x square. Okay, so y equals to x square and y equals to fx. Now we can obviously find out integrating of this function minus integration of this function. The main part to look at is that from where to where the limit goes. Okay, so for, let's say this is some any point x, and then the y coordinate of this point will become x square, because this function is y equals to x square. So that point will be x comma x square. So this area minus of this function's area will grow from 0 to any point x, which is r. Okay, so this area will become integration x square minus f of x 0 to x. Now you may get confused that this and this are x. So let's put it to any value, say t. Okay, and this will again becomes t and dot dt. So this area will define this area. Okay, so on integrating, we got here integration of t square will become t cube by 3. Limits are from 0 to x. And for this function, because we don't know what this function is, so we'll keep it in the form of integral. So this will become integration 0 to x f of t dt. Remember, this is the area for this function, and we'll keep it as this for now. And this is our equation 1. Okay, so this is the area of the function which is downward. So I think you understand this, so I'll rub this and I'll put it here, that area 1 equals to t cube by x cube by 3 minus f of t integral dt 0 to x. This is our area 1. Now we have to find out what is this area. So by looking at this, we cannot find out, it's difficult to find out area of this quadrant with respect to x, because these functions are not coming in x. So what we'll do is that we'll find this area with respect to y. That means instead of integrating this area, what we are going to do is we are going to integrate like this, this area. That means with respect to y, nothing has changed. We are just changing the axis, or we are just changing the area with which we are integrating. So for this, we have to convert all these functions in terms of y. So, and the function which are involved are y equals to 2x and y equals to x square. So y equals to 2x, that means x becomes y by 2, and y equals to x square, that means root y equals to x. Okay, so our two functions that we are going to use in find out the area is this first function and the second function. So area 2, what area 2 will be? Integration, what is the function that is far away, that is this function y equals to x square. So this function will come first, root y minus this function, because we are finding area in this direction. So root y minus y by 2 dy. Now, okay, we can write this easily, but what are the limits? Where the limit will stand? Because we have to put some limit, let's say from 0 to somewhere. Where is that limit? So, because these functions are going from 0 to x, I mean these functions are going from 0 to here, so at the value of x, this point is x square, the y point is x square. So this function will integrate from 0 to x square, because at this point y is equals to x square, okay, from this function. So the limit goes from 0 to x square, so putting the limit 0 to x square. So this is the area of our second function. Now we can integrate it simply. This is root y, so y to the power 3 by 2 upon 3 by 2, okay, minus this will become y square by there is a 2, so that 2 will come down, 2 to the 4, okay, y to the power 3 by 2 upon 3 by 2, integration of this part, and the integration of this part, y square upon 4. Now putting the limits from 0 to x square, okay, so what this limits will be, putting x square here, that will become x cube 2 by 3 minus putting x square here, x to the power 4 upon 4. Okay, so this is the second area. Okay, so this is the area that we have. Now there are two areas. Now this area and this area is equal, as the condition says. So what was our area 1? Our area 1 was x cube by 3 minus integration of 0 to x f of t dt equals to 2x cube by 3 minus x to the power 4 by 4. Okay. Now, this function still remains in integral form, and we have to find out f of x. So what we'll do is that we'll integrate this whole equation. Okay, we'll differentiate this whole equation, so that this integration and differentiation will get cancelled out and we get f of x. So differentiating, this will become 3x square by 3 minus, now on differentiating this integration and differentiation will cancel, and x and 0 will come here. So f of x, remember f of 0 is 0 from the figure, so we are not taking f of 0, equals to, this 3 will come ahead, differentiation of this will be 3 into 2x square by 3 minus, this 4 will come, x cube by 4. Okay, so on differentiating this equation, we get this equation. Now rearranging and simplifying, what is the, we get f of x. What is f of x? X square minus 2x square plus x cube equals to f of x. Okay, now again simplifying, x cube minus x square equals to f of x. So in this way we find out that this is the function fx which was the required and which was desired in the question. So this was the question which was asked in 1992-8 for 8 marks, and this was the question and the whole procedure to solve it. I hope you have enjoyed this session, and if you have any queries you can comment. Thank you.